Georgia-Pacific is one of the leading structural wood panel producers in the world, making plywood and OSB panels for wall, roof, and floor sheathing for construction. One of the key elements in a sound structure is a properly constructed home. We'd like to share a few tips with you about proper installation of plywood and OSB panels, and in this video, we'll talk about sturdy floor panels for subfloors. For detailed instructions, visit builditbetter.com or apawood.org. Once you've chosen a high-quality panel for your subfloor, be sure to select the proper thickness or span rating. Be sure to take into consideration the applied load, joist spacing, the finished flooring, and the floor system. First, lay the panels over two or more supports with the long dimension or strength axis across the supports. Ends must be over the supports, and the panel should be staggered at least two supports. The ends of the panel should occur at approximately the center of the support with a minimum bearing of 1/2 inch. If your panels are tongue and groove, they should be butted lightly together with the side marked this side down resting on the supports. And be sure to leave a 1/8 inch gap at the panel ends. If you are using square edge panels, they should have a 1/8 inch gap on all four sides. Depending on your local building codes, the long edge of the panel should be tongue and groove, or should be supported by blocking underneath. If the finished floor is 3/4 inch thick hardwoods installed perpendicular to the panels, 1.5 inches of lightweight concrete, or if there's an additional layer of 1/4 inch underlayment, then the blocking is not required. The panels should be fastened with wood screws, common or deformed shank nails, or other approved fasteners. Power-driven nails can be used if not overdriven. For panels up to and including 3/4 performance category, 6D deformed shank or 8D common nails are recommended. For panels 7/8 performance category and thicker, 8D deformed shank nails are recommended. The panels may be glued to the joists for optimal floor stiffness and reduced floor squeaks. Apply a bead of glue along the joist and in the panel grooves. Then fasteners should be placed 3/8 inch from the edge and spaced 6 inches apart along the panel edges and 12 inches apart along the intermediate supports. Make sure to install all the fasteners before the glue cures, and be sure to sand any uneven joints before installing the finished flooring. Please refer to your local building codes as they may impose additional or different installation instructions. For detailed installation instructions, visit builditbetter.com or apawood.org.